Now let's discuss some of the issues with scalability of the synchronization primitives in a shared memory multiprocessor. Now we already saw that locks, both mutual exclusion as well as shared lock, is one type of synchronization operation. And we also saw that barrier algorithms is another type of synchronization operations. And when you look at both of these guys, both of these types of synchronization primitives that a parallel operating system is going to provide for application programmer developing multi-threaded applications, the sources of inefficiencies that come about is, first of all, latency. What do we mean by that? Well, if this thread wants to acquire this lock, it has to do some operation. It has to go to memory, get that lock, and make sure that nobody else is competing with it. And so that's the latency. That is, inherently, what is the time that is spent by a thread in acquiring the lock? That's what we mean by latency. Or to be more precise, what we mean is that latency is saying, lock is currently not being used. How long does it take for me to go and get it? That's really the key question that latency is trying to look at. The second source of scalability with synchronization is the waiting time. And that is, if I want to go and get the lock, how long do I wait in order to get that lock? Well, clearly, this is not something that you and I, as the OS designer, has complete control over, because it really depends on what these threads are doing with this lock. So for instance, if this thread acquires this lock and then it is modifying the data for a long time before releasing it, and if another thread comes along and wants that same lock, it's going to wait for a long time. So the waiting time is really in the purview of the application, and there's not much you can do as an OS designer in reducing the waiting time. The third source of unscalability of locks is contention. What we mean by that is, if currently some guy is using the lock and he releases it, when the lock is released, it's now up for grabs. Maybe there's, I've shown you only one thread here, but maybe there's a bunch of threads waiting here to access this particular lock. If they're all waiting to access this lock, they're all contending for this lock. And how long does it take in the presence of contention for one of them to become the winner of the lock and the others to go away? So that's the contention part of implementing a synchronization primitive. And all of these things, latency, waiting time, and contention, even though I mentioned it in the context of a mutual exclusion lock, appears when you're talking about barrier synchronization algorithms or shared locks. So latency and contention are two things, as OS designers, we have to be always worried about in implementing scalable versions of synchronization primitives.